Onboarding new employees for pre-employment or new non-employees, always begin by checking Search Match to see if they already exist in PeopleSoft, and they might if they are past or current Stony Brook University students, employees, or affiliates, and using Search Match will prevent them perhaps being in PeopleSoft twice. To get an idea of whether the person might already be in the system, ask them if they've ever done anything with or at Stony Brook University. The searches for IDs and names like this that you might find in employee data are not the same as Search Match. To access Search Match, click on Main Menu, Campus Community, Personal Information, Search Match. On the first page, don't enter anything, just click Search. If this is your first time using Search Match, start by setting your default search result code. Click on User Default, and then the magnifying glass, and then click on the search result code in the results. Click OK and your default will be saved for any future uses of Search Match. When using Search Match, always search in two steps, Social Security Number search and then first and last name search. Here's how. In the National ID value box, enter the person's Social Security Number, click the Tab key on your keyboard, and then click Search. If there are no results, second, search by first and last name. Click OK, remove the Social Security number, type the first name, click the Tab key on the keyboard, type the last name, click Tab key again, and then click Search. If you still find no results, add the person as a new non-employee or new employee for pre-employment. But if you find results, either by searching for Social Security number or first and last name, you need to verify if they are the same person. In some cases, you might see several results that are actually the same person with different name types. Other times, the results are different people. To verify that you have found an exact match, click on the Results 2 tab to compare the birthday of the person and the match. If they match, don't add the person newly to PeopleSoft. Instead, update the person's information for pre-employment or non-employees. You'll need the employee ID to update information, so select, right-click on, and then copy the employee ID. If you need to do another search, click Return to Search Criteria.